my dear students, welcome back to this mini HS school. I believe you are all happy and safe at home. Welcome you all back to this English revision class. So, already I said you, right? Yes, today we are going to revise our grammar portions, that is from the grammar tree book. We already revised the portions from students' book as well as workbook. So the remaining is grammar tree book. So today we are going to see portions from grammar tree book. So let's think about it. How many lessons? Yes, we completed 9 chapters till naming words 2. So let's see the titles first, next into detail. First chapter, names of things. Second, names of some more things. Third, every morning. Fourth, my toys and games. Fifth, names of living things, animals and birds. Sixth, some more names, animals and birds. Seventh, names of living things and non-living things. Eighth, naming words part 1. And ninth, naming words part 2. So these are the chapters we studied before, and today we are going to revise it in detail. So before getting into our class, I would like to have a warm-up exercise for you. So today's warm-up exercise is, before I say about the warm-up exercise, please take this as serious. It will help you not only get into the class as well as to develop your language skills, pronunciation, reading, everything. Okay, because last class I received very few warm-up exercises. So today's warm-up exercises, on today we saw about counting vowels. Today we are going to see about counting consonants. Clear? So let me give you 5 words here. First word is helmet. How many vowels are here? One vowel, yes, E. It was there in 2 times, but you have to consider as one. Yeah, one vowel. We have 5 vowels, A, E, I, O, U. And here we have only one letter, that is E. So consonant counting. So first, how many letters are there in this word? 6 letter word. How many vowels? We had one vowel. H is a consonant, one consonant, plus, yeah, E is a vowel, L is a consonant, one. Any other L is here? No. Then M is a consonant, one. Any other M is here? No. E is a vowel and T is a consonant. Any other T is here? No. So one. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 4. So how many consonants are here in this word? 4 consonants. Let me give you another one example, that is glitter. Yes, G, is it consonant or vowel? Yeah, it's a consonant. So, one, any other G here? No, so okay, cancel it. L, is it consonant or vowel? It's a consonant, one. Any other L is here? No, so cancel it. I is the consonant or vowel? It's a vowel. So next, leave that. T. T is a consonant or vowel? It's a consonant. Cut. One. Any other T? Cut that too. But you have to count like one. E is a consonant or vowel? It's a vowel. And finally, R. R is a consonant. So cut here. And put here 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many consonants are here? 4. If the letter repeats, count that as 1. Clear? 4 consonants. So your practice is going to be on listen, stairs, and sound. So your practice is going to be on listen, stairs, and sound. L-I-S-T-E-N, S-T-A-I-R-S, S-O-U-N-D. So totally 3 words for you. Count the consonants here. Clear? So, shall we move to our grammar part? First, chapter 1, names of things. What does it mean by names of things? Usually we play picture words. See, I said you already. Warm-up exercise will help you in studying our lessons too. Yeah, the same. Names of things synthesis? Yeah, we are doing that in picture words. We have names for each and everything that we see. We have name for each and everything that we see. For example, this thing. Is that have some name? Yes, green board. This thing, is that have any names? Yes, paper. This thing, is that have any names? Clear this. Is that have any names? Yes, it's a bag. So this thing, is that have any name? Chalk piece. So each and everything that we see that has its own name. So that is names of things. Here they have mentioned like some non-living things. Non-living things, living things that we can see in upcoming chapters. So these are things. Each and everything have name. So in chapter 1 you have things like cap, book, cup, boat, apple, tree, flowers, fish, so things. Okay, so next chapter is also more about this because there are more names of things, so the same. So the third chapter, every morning. So we are using many things after the moment we wake from our bed. Example, we are sleeping on cot. It's a thing. So these are the things below. Everything has some names. So every morning we are using some same things that we are repeating in every mornings. Clear? So that things we can see in chapter 3. For example, toothbrush, comb, hairbrush, shampoo, paste. So these things are very common. We used to use in our daily basis. So that we are given in chapter 3. Chapter 4. My toys and games. So we are using, you kids, you are grade 1 kids, and so you may like many toys and you may like many games. And that game says, and the toys may also have some peculiar name. It's a thing, right? It's a thing, and that thing must have some name. So you should know that name. You know that. You may play with doll. Sometimes you don't know that real English name for that doll. So it's doll. Likewise, everything. Some robots, some trucks, cars. You used to play with us. Like games in the sense, chess set, chess board, those things. Bat and ball, these are our playing equipments. And all playing equipments as well as games have their own names. Then chapter 5, names of living things. Before seeing this, I would like to explain chapter 7. Chapter 7, names of living things as well as non-living things. What is mean by living things? What is mean by non-living things? Each element here in this world is some kind of thing. Clear? But that can be differentiated into living things as well as non-living things. Clear? For example, let's take like this. Me and this chopper. Myself and this chopper. I'm also a thing in this world. This is also a thing in this world. But this is non-living thing. And myself and living thing. That is living being. Clear? So how can you find that? I have flesh, bone, blood, and I can speak, and I can shout. I have my own desires. I can do what and all I wish myself. But this chopper, these things cannot play on their roles on their own. Clear? So this chalk piece needs somebody to make use of. Clear? This chalk is. Without my hands, this cannot write on green board. Clear? With my hand or some other's hand? This needs some other to attain its job. But myself, I can do it all my own. This is the difference between living things and non-living things. Living things can do their duties on their own, but non-living things cannot do anything without the help of living things. It depends on living things. Non-living things depends on living things. But living things can stand alone. Clear? This is the difference between non-living things and living things. Clear? So, 7th chapter is all about this, and I left 5th and 6th chapter. Yes, 5th and 6th is like names of living things and some more names of living things. So, these things that can we see in chapter 5 and 6, like animals, birds, reptiles, those all living things. Then, chapter 8 and chapter 9. Chapter 8. I detailed already. Yes, chapter 8 is naming words part 1. Chapter 9 is naming words part 2. Naming words. What is mean by naming words? I already said that this is the basic for grammar. Naming words in the sense noun. N-O-U-N. Noun is equal to naming words. So nouns is equal to naming words. What is mean by name? The same. We said it. There is. Yes. Each thing has some kind of name. But in naming words session, we can differentiate that in parts. For example, naming words works under four main blocks. What are they? People, animals, place, and things. People, animals, place, and things. So naming words comes under these four categories. Let me give you an example. My name is Persia. So you can make your name here. So naming word is? Yes, Persia. So Persia comes under people or animals or place or things. Let's pick like this. Persia have blood, bone, flesh, and she can speak. So it must be considered people or animals. Am I animal? No, I'm a people. So I comes under people. So you can write here Persia. So this is how differentiating. I love dogs. I love dogs. So here dogs. Naming words is dogs. So dog comes under. Yeah, it has flesh, skin, blood. So it must be comes under people or animal. Is that dog is a people? No, it comes under animal. So you can write dog here. I works at Karangal. So here, naming word is, yes, Karangal. So does Karangal has flesh, bone, blood? No. So that must comes under place or thing. So Karangal is a place or thing. Is there an object or a place? Karangal is not an object, so it's a place. You can write Karangal here. I used to carry a laptop with me. So laptop is a naming word. So laptop. Does laptop has any flesh, bone, blood? No. So that must be considered place or things. Is laptop is an object or place? Yes, it's a object. So it must comes under things. So here, laptop, computer. So see, this is how we differentiate things into four blocks. So naming words can be differentiated into people, animals, place and things. So as special case, that is, under animals we have birds and reptiles too. Under animals we have birds and reptiles too. Clear? Birds and reptiles. So this is all about naming words. I believe you are now very familiar in your English portions, that is chapter 1, 2, 3. What are the chapters? The Great Big Turnip, Dish of Mother's Apple Pie, Rani's First Day at School, and grammar portions. 9 grammar chapters and workbook the same and student's book. So I believe you are now very much thorough in your lessons. I'm expecting your involvement in examination. Please don't copy. Parents, you are the examiner for your kids. So please be loyal and genuine. Okay, students, all the best for your examination. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.